to me of the old days of Rav Shlaimala, when we more than listened to him as a performer, got together for little kumzitzes, and those went all night. And we could sing one niggun for an hour and just began getting into it. Today, people don't know how to participate, how to get involved in a niggun. Before you finish the niggun, they're waiting for the next one. That's a process, really, to be feeling, experiencing, and living in the niggun. So it's a request that we have to try to make this evening something, and it's really a pleasure to be with such Hoshiva people on air on board. But I'd like to start with a niggun that goes back to our first album, 1967. Some of you might not have been born. A mensch bracht in der Ebeste lach. That kind of expression sounds a bit cynical. I don't really think it's an appropriate translation or explanation of Rabos Machshavos Belev Ish. Because in the spirit of Bitachon and Amuna, it might be just the opposite. A person doesn't think and imagine the beautiful and wonderful things that can happen to him, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu showers him with things beyond his imagination, beyond his belief. And if we look at life that way, there's a kind of a Sameach Bechelko, which we're supposed to bring about in the coming month of Simcha. And the real Simcha is someone who is Sameach Bechelko. Rabos Machshavos Belev Ish. Rivi, I hope you remember it. It's been a long time.
Thank you.
1947, and my Rebbe of Kanarik at that time sang a little niggun in Yiddish. And the niggun went something like this. Und die ganze Welt ist a schmaler Brick, an old-fashioned Yiddish niggun. And I asked Rav Kanarik, Shlita, where are these words from? And he says, well, I think originally they're in a text in Rav Nachman Breslov, and the words are Kol Ha'olam Kulo Gesher Tzar Ma'od. I looked up the words, found them by Rav Nachman, and after the Yom Kippur War, we were sitting out near Gush Etzion with soldiers and tanks.
Please join us. Share time.
is a song that I'd like to share with you that a little boy asked me to write a niggun to these words. Unfortunately, the little boy passed away. And in his memory, they built an incredible organization for Menachem Merenthal and Baiva Guy. And the only thing that helped him get through the pain of his terrible disease, cancer, was music. He loved music and asked us to come and play and sing. We brought boys from all over. Motzei Shabbos and other times to his home in Beit Hagan. And one night he asked me, Baruch, there are words that I think about a lot. And this is the niggun. liked eventually to teach in Nuniggen, which when I was called about this weekend, about this evening, I was told about Rabbi Winyard Zalav HaShalom. And we experienced in our own family, unfortunately, just about 2-3 weeks ago, my mother-in-law, Zalav HaShalom, passed away. And it was a mindset of sorrow, grief. And when I heard about the Talmud, I woke up 2 in the morning, couldn't go back to sleep. And the niggun was haunting.
Thank you. Hannah.